From monsters you can walk through to sandy constructions, we will take you through some of the most unbelievable outdoor sculpture parks in the world. And the best thing about outdoor art, you can snack while you enjoy it. 11 unbelievable sculpture parks. Olympic Sculpture Park, Seattle, Washington. In 2007, this 8.5-acre green lung opened in downtown Seattle. It was previously an industrial site occupied by an oil and gas corporation in the 1970s, but became a contaminated brownfield. The Seattle Art Museum proposed the idea of rehabilitating the area into a green space and incorporating public art installations. The park is now revitalized from a contaminated industrial brownfield into a waterfront park, free to visitors to walk through a living gallery. Sculptures by Alexander Calder, Mark Di Severo, and Elsworth Kelly are included, and the collection is growing. Antoni Gaudí's Park, Güell, Barcelona, Spain. If you visit Antoni Gaudí's Park, Güell, you will probably never guess that it was a failure to begin with. The park was originally intended as a housing development for the wealthy. Far from the factory smog, the socialite and businessman Count Eusebi Güell decided to begin a wealthy housing estate. He built two homes, one that he occupied and the other he convinced Antoni Gaudí to buy. Gaudí occupied the home with his family from 1906 to 1926, but unfortunately, the housing project never took off. Not all was lost, as Gaudí left his indelible mark on his home by sculpting mosaiced beasts, ornate colonnades, and tree-shaped birds' nests, which he crafted along with several of his collaborators. His house is also a museum, and the remaining land around the abandoned housing project was transformed into a municipal garden that is a historical monument worth visiting. Sand festivals worldwide. The impermanence of sandcastles is what makes them so exciting. Knowing that this work of art only remains between tides is what makes us treasure them so much more. Sandcastle building competitions are a summer activity at beachside resorts around the world. But since 2003, Portugal has been taking the summer fun to a whole new level. The International Sand Sculpture Festival is a gathering of sand sculpture artists from around the world. The event takes place in Pira, Algarve, Portugal, every year. Each of the 60 artists get 35,000 tons of sand to work with. They have to create 50 works of art, each more elaborate and detailed than the next. The beaches are open for visitors to walk through the 3.7 acres of sculptures. In the evenings, the sand sculptures are illuminated with atmospheric lighting. Bomaso, Viterbo, Italy. When Salvador Dali made a short film about this sculpture park in the 1950s, it promoted a quick response to restore the grounds. The garden was created in the 16th century and is locally known as Parco dei Mostri, or Park of the Monsters. It contains large, grotesque monster figures carved out of bedrock. It displays good examples of monumental mannerist sculptures. There are also small buildings hidden within the natural vegetation of the wooded valley bottom beneath the local castle or Orsini. In the 16th century, the park was not created as works of art to please the viewer, but rather just to set the heart free, as an inscription on an obelisk in the park states. The subject matter is random, and there doesn't seem to be a single theme or plan. One large sculpture depicts Hannibal's fighting elephants, which mangles a Roman legionary. Another is of Ceres lounging on the bare ground, with a vase of verdure perched on her head. Like many mannerists' work of art, the symbolism is mysterious. Frogner Park, Oslo, Norway. This sculpture park is truly a showstopper. The sheer vastness of the body of work is incredible. 212 sculptures in total. But even more incredible is that they were all created by a single artist, Gustav Vigeland. Gustav Vigeland was a popular Norwegian sculptor that lived from 1896 to 1943. The significance of this is that Frogner Park, featuring his 212 works, was only started in 1939 and completed in 1949, 6 years after his passing. Some of the most well-known pieces are Angry Boy, depicting a toddler having a tantrum with perfect observation. Frogner Park also consists of larger structures, such as bridges and fountains, created by Vigeland. He also created clay versions of each sculpture, which were later cast in bronze or carved from granite. His motivating vision for the park was to create a true public space for the people of Oslo and beyond. And with over 1 million visitors to the park each year, it seems he has achieved his goal. Yorkshire Sculpture Park, UK. The Yorkshire Sculpture Park is the first of its kind in the UK and also the largest in Europe. It spans 500 acres across the rolling Yorkshire hillside and contains a rotating body of temporary works as well as many permanent pieces. Open-air works include artists such as Julian Oppie, Tom Price and Thomas Halsego. Other world greats that have been hosted include Henry Moore and James Tyrrell. The park contains the 500 acres of outdoor landscape and 5 indoor galleries. The Yorkshire Sculpture Park was named the Museum of the Year in 2014. Nikki de Saint Fuller's Tarot Garden, Tuscany, Italy. Nikki de Saint Fuller is an eccentric artist. She even lived inside one of the Empress sculptures for a few months during the construction of the Tarot Garden. Her garden reflects the fun and larger-than-life mosaics of Gaudí's Park in Barcelona. The construction of the statues is reinforced concrete covered in mosaics with mirror shards. With a strong, voluptuous feminine style, the statues were designed large enough to be explored or clambered over. Nikki de Saint Fuller built 22 massive sculptures based around the tarot characters. She began in 1979, after acquiring some land on top of an Etruscan ruin in Garavicchio. Tarot Garden was opened to the public in 1998 and remains open today. Hakone Open Air Museum, Kanagawa Prefecture, Japan. This was the first open-air museum to be opened in Japan in 1969. Since then, it has amassed an incredible collection of traditional inside exhibition art and over 1,000 outdoor sculptures. The museum grounds cover over 70,000 square meters, or 17 acres, of perfectly manicured lawns. The grounds even contain a natural hot spring that you can rest your feet in if you get tired from walking around. The inside section comprises of 5 exhibition halls, which house a permanent collection of 300 works by Picasso. As if that isn't enough artist A-list for you, they also own works by Brancusi and Renier in their permanent collection. The joy of outdoor sculpture parks is that you can often interact with the art. It is a fantastic living park, blending a collection of traditional art with a body of new vibrant works. Aia Napa Sculpture Park, Cyprus, Greece. The first phase of the Aia Napa Sculpture Park was to clean up the area and plant 1,500 Cypriot trees and plants. This was in an effort to enrich the natural wealth of the area. Since 2013, the second phase of landscaping began. Now the park is still a work in progress as sculptures are being introduced. It truly is transforming before your eyes as local stone is transported to the site and artists work on their sculptures in the park. Artists like Austrian artist Thomas Eller, Italian Stefano Sabetta, and Australian Jürgen Juen have all been hosted to create work. Legoland Global. Let's not forget the first place most of us attempted a sculpture, Lego. But the Legoland theme parks we are talking about contain much more advanced sculptures to ogle at. How about a Lego Mount Rushmore or Eiffel Tower or just about any global landmark you can imagine, all made from plastic Lego blocks? Thankfully, there isn't just one Legoland in the world. Since 1968, there have been opening Legoland resorts around the globe. On top of the incredible Lego statues, they also contain various entertainment options like roller coasters, theatrics, and water parks. But one thing is standard. Each Lego park contains Miniland, a model village of all the landmarks in the world that you can walk through like Godzilla and feel like a child again. Have you ever visited any of these unbelievable sculpture parks? We'd love to hear about your experience in the comments below. 1. Molinier Underwater Sculpture Park, Grenada. The Molinier Underwater Sculpture Park was created by British sculptor Jason de Keers Taylor. The aim of the underwater park was to invite people to engage with the underwater environment. The park began its construction in 2006 on the sandy ocean floor of Molinier Bay. The bay is barren, and by sinking sculptures at this location, the hope was that it would navigate tourists away from the nearby natural coral reefs. The reefs were showing dieback from too much tourism and damage from devastating hurricanes in 2004 and 2005. The sculpture park consists of 65 concrete individual sculptures spread over 800 square meters. The human sculptures are derived from life casts of the local community. The sculptures range from solitary individuals to groups. One well-recognized piece is a ring of children holding hands, facing out to the ocean currents. The park is accessible by boat from St. George's, the main port, or from Grand Anse Bay on the west coastline. The deepest piece is placed at 12 meters, or 40 feet, aimed at scuba divers, but plenty are shallower and suitable for snorkeling. You can also stay drive and observe them from a glass-bottom boat tour. The art continues to attract new life and new meaning as the environment begins to encroach naturally on the space. The sculptures are now home to coral and shrimp, fireworms and flounders, even parrotfish come around for a peek. Pulling the focus away from the natural coral reefs in the area has also given them much-needed breathing room to recover.